Good morning and thank you for coming here today. My name is Sergeant Autumn Luby. I'm with the Lower Paxton Township Bureau of Police. Today we are here to discuss an update on the death investigation of Justin Johnson. In just a moment, you will hear from several individuals involved in the investigation. They are Lower Paxton Township Manager, Mr. Bradley Gutshaw, Dauphin County District Attorney, Fran Chardo, Public Safety Director of Lower Paxton Township Bureau of Police, Director Adam Kosheba, and Pennsylvania State Police Corporal Aaron Allen. Mr. Gutshaw.
Well, hello everyone. Thank you for joining us to help get some information out on this difficult moment here. You know, as a father myself to two beautiful young children in the earliest parts of their public school careers, I just want to take this moment to extend to Mr. Johnson and his family and friends my personal heartfelt condolences during this difficult time. As a township manager receiving briefs on this matter from the beginning of this investigation, I can easily deliver my personal assessment that law enforcement representing this case has been thorough and set out with objectivity in mind. From my vantage point, I can once again state how confident the township administration is in the fine work our police bureau does every day, and of course during this particular investigation. We also want to thank those external agencies that have once again stepped up to assist in this complex and thorough investigation. Thank you very much.
I cannot fully imagine the pain and sense of loss experienced by the family of Justin Johnson. We convey our condolences and express our hope that we can provide some answers to the family. But our investigation is not complete. We have a large team working on this investigation. The Lower Paxton Township Bureau of Police is the lead agency. We have assistance. The Criminal Investigation Division in my office and the Pennsylvania State Police are providing assistance. The analysts from the Pennsylvania State Police have been invaluable in this effort, and we continue to investigate this matter so that we can have a complete investigation before we report on our findings. If anyone watching has any pertinent information, I encourage them to contact the Lower Paxton Township Bureau of Police. We're looking for any information that can advance this investigation. But as I say that, I want to observe that we have gotten information that, posted on Facebook, on Penn Live's Facebook, from individuals purporting to have direct knowledge that didn't have any direct knowledge. And when we followed up, they posted information on Facebook claiming that they had knowledge. When interviewed, they said, "I didn't have any knowledge. I just thought that's what sort of people wanted to read." And so we want people with actual knowledge so that we can follow up and learn the truth. Detectives will continue their investigation, and we will continue this investigation to get all the pertinent facts. And when the investigative phase has concluded, we will return and we will report fully so that the public knows our findings and the next steps when the investigative phase is concluded. Thank you, Director.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Adam Kosheba. I'm the Director of Public Safety here in Lower Paxton Township. Before I begin, I too would like to express our agency's most sincere condolences to the Johnson family, specifically Mr. Johnson, the Johnson family, and friends. My intent this morning is to provide you with updated information relating to this investigation as we know today. Understand that this information is just that, it's an update. This investigation, as you have heard from the district attorney, is still ongoing, and there is a lot more to do. We have discovered thus far from extensive interviews, forensic downloads from numerous devices, video evidence, and many other avenues, several things. So everyone has an idea of the magnitude of just the cellular data that we're trying to analyze. One device, just one device that we have examined thus far, had contained over 250 gigs of data, and that forensic download took 2 days to complete, and we're not speaking of the analyzing of that data, just the download. At this point, I'd like to examine a timeline of events as we know today. You'll see on the screen here, and we'll provide that with you later, a printed version of this. It begins with 422, April 422. I'm going to speak to that later on. So I want to move into the date in question, April 26th. There are several notes up there. I'm going to bring you to a few targeted points for you within that timeline. 8:20 p.m. on 426. Four male friends arrive at the Johnson's residence in three vehicles. The male friends will not be identified at this time by name due to their age. Simply, they're juveniles and we can't release them. However, I will share with you that two of the male friends were white male friends, age 16 years of age. There was one biracial male, age 16, and one Asian male, age 16. At 8:23, three friends are seen on the video knocking on Justin's door. And at that particular time, there's been discussion out and you've seen the video, one male has this water gun. As you can see, a white and green water gun. At 8:26, Justin is heard on the doorbell video saying, "Hold on, I have to get my," and we couldn't make out the rest of the audio. At 8:27, the doorbell video shows Justin yelling to his friends about signing a contract and showing his phone as he's yelling to them. What we know at this point is very brief. The contract is related to the game itself, and we are still trying to obtain additional information of what that contract means. Next, we see Justin running off as he's being chased. At 8:29, p.m., a male friend returns to Justin's porch. He intentionally places himself on video and he puts Justin's phone on a chair. Interviews suggest that he still had Justin's phone in exchange when there was a discussion about the contract, so he was placing it back on the chair for Justin. At 8:31 p.m., we know from video that all four juvenile friends leave the area. At 8:36 p.m., Justin appears on video walking up to his house, onto the porch, and moving the chair. He looks at his phone that was left by one of his male friends. At 8:37, Mr. Johnson explained to detectives that he spoke with Justin on the phone and that Justin told him he was running around with some boys and they were playing tag. At 8:42, Justin texted the snap group that was created that we'll speak of soon, "Yeah, you were never going to catch me." The next point I'll bring up to you is at 9:45 p.m., Mr. Johnson arrives home and finds Justin unconscious. So now the context of the game. So let's go back to the date that I had mentioned, April 22nd, 2024. And that's when all this begins. A snap thread is started about the game. The Life 360 app is required to play this game, and the code for the app is put out on the thread. At this point, we have identified over 22 juveniles who at one time or another were participating in the game. The following two slides on the screen reveal just some of the snap communications of the players in the game. The names of these individuals were redacted due to their age. However, for contextual purposes, Justin, his name remains. Now let me explain how the game works at this point as we know it. The timeline was established for the game early on, April 22nd, and the game would continue until midnight on April 26th. The rules that we know it thus far are that to be tagged, the tag must be witnessed by 3 to 5 people within the game, or it must be recorded on video. Interviews conducted suggest that that is why the one juvenile on the video released on social media is heard, "Get this on video." Additionally, no tagging can occur during sporting events. Next, I would like to show everyone a short montage of videos extracted from just one cellular device, showing participants in the game that was occurring both in school and out of school. You will see Justin Johnson in one of these videos. The faces of the others have been redacted. Next, I would like to introduce Corporal Aaron Allen of the Pennsylvania State Police Heritage Affairs Section. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. First, I want to send my condolences to the Johnson family. My name is Corporal Aaron Allen with the Pennsylvania State Police Heritage Affairs Office. What my office does, we respond, we investigate, we monitor any sort of hate crimes, bias-related incidents, or any acts of racial tension that happened throughout the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. Some incidents that I've been heavily involved in and our office has responded to and monitored have been the Tree of Life Synagogue massacre that happened right in the Pittsburgh area, and the East Pittsburgh shooting with Antoine Rose Jr., amongst a lot of other high profile incidents of that manner. My office was brought in very early within this investigation as an additional resource throughout this investigation. We will continue to work closely with the Lower Paxton Police Department, District Attorney's Office, and any other resource to make sure there's no hate or bias detected within this investigation. I want to ensure to the public that the Lower Paxton Police Department, Pennsylvania State Police, and all other resources are exhausting all resources available to ensure a thorough investigation. Thank you.
Thank you all for coming today. As we continue to gain information about this investigation, we will continue to provide updates with that information. We will not be taking any questions today. Thank you all for coming.